Hello friends, today we are starting our chapter number 2, that is basic accounting terms. We will gonna learn this chapter in 4 parts. First one is the basic terms you should be aware about, as if you are not going to enter these terms, but still you should be aware of these terms to know what you are doing. The next part is receipts, expenditure and expenses. One should be know about the types of receipts, types of expenditure and difference between expenditure and expenses, and the types of expenses. We will learn these 4 points in this concept. Apart from this, the next part is income statement. Income statement. In this point, you will learn about the concepts of income statement and the entries you will do in income statement. The last part is related to the balance sheet. All the transactions that are related to the balance sheet, such as assets, liabilities or other or type of assets or liabilities, capital drawings, etc. You will learn those part of balance sheet in this point. Okay, now starting one by one, our first point is basic terms. In basic terms, we will learn about those basic terms which do not affect any of the elements, but still you should be aware of the basic terms while doing accounting. Few of the basic terms are business transactions. See, business transaction basically does not affect any of your account, but still without business transaction no accounting can take place. Secondly, account. What account mean? You must be aware of while doing accounting. Books of account. What we mean by book of account? Obviously, while preparing accounts, we must know what we mean by books of accounts and in which account one entry should be placed. Next, entry. As I said that while preparing accounts, we should know about in which account entry should be placed, but without knowing what entry mean, can we post any entry? Obviously not. So we should be aware of what entry mean as well. Next, debit and credit. These two terms are very important terms in your account, without which no account can be prepared. But still, you will see that no debit or credit are the separate element of any of book of accounts. Still, without debit or credit, no book of account can be prepared. Next, proprietor. Okay, in basic terms, we will learn about these 6 terms one by one. Thank you. So, our first term was business transactions. What we mean by business transaction? In our first chapter, we have learned about the term financial transactions and events. Financial transactions and event, by which we mean something of money value, right? By the term financial transaction, we mean any of the transaction, any of the buying or selling or anything, any transaction or any event which took place in terms of money. But in case of business, we mean business transaction as any type of financial transaction or event but in terms of business, that is entry in between two parties. Financial transaction can be said as a pocket money, paid by a father to his child, but in case of business transaction, it should be taken place in between two parties. A father and a son are not two business parties, but they are just family members. So in case of business transaction by two parties, transaction that took place are such as sale of stock, purchase of stock, exchange of some product, etc. So in case of business transaction, what we mean by business transaction is any type of financial transaction in between business, that is in between two different business parties. Okay, now coming towards our second basic transaction, that is account. What we mean by account? As we said, we transfer all the transaction, all the business transaction in some account. So we can say account as a summarized record of transactions relating to the particular head at one place. Say you purchased some product and even sold as well some stock as well. Account is something which state all the purchases and all the sales you have made during the accounting period. It is basically the summarized record of all the transactions relating to the particular head. If we are speaking about the purchases, then account will show all the purchases you have made during the accounting period. Okay, now coming towards our third basic transaction, that is books of account. Just like account is a summarized record. By books of account, we mean to say those books in which transactions are recorded such as cash book is basically the book in which all the transactions in cash are recorded together, whether the sales made or whether the purchase, but on the basis of cash, are recorded in the cash book. In case of purchase account, as I said, it is a summarized record. We mean to say that all the purchases are made, whether a cash basis or whether a credit basis. But if we speak about a cash book, if we say about the book, it means all those transactions which are made on cash basis are recorded. Here the term account is used, but in case of books of account, we use it as cash book, and it is basically a separate chapter as well. In account, you will study that these are prepared while you will learn ledger account. But in this case, in book of account, for cash book, you will learn a separate chapter known as cash book, and for purchase book or some other book, say sales book. As these are book, it means you will have to learn subsidiary books to learn about purchase book and sales book. In these two, basically the credit purchases or credit sales are recorded. So in cash book, we will record all the transactions done on cash basis, but in other books, we will transfer all the credit based transactions. This is the difference between book of account or account. Coming towards our fourth basic term, that is entry. What we mean by entry, as I said that we in book of account we are going to post some entry. But what we mean by entry? It is basically a transaction or event when recorded in the books of account are known as entry. So we can say if we are going to post or record some transaction or event in the books of account, we will call it as entry. Okay, now coming towards our fifth term, that is debit and credit. See, this is very important term without which no account can be prepared. To learn these two terms, we need to classify these terms as, basically accounts are divided into two parts. One is debit and other is credit. As I have written debit on the left, I mean to say that while preparing some account, our left side is called as debit and the right side is called as credit. On the left side, if we are placing some entry, say to cash account, we mean to say that the term cash has been debited. It means the term has been added. And if we are crediting some amount, that is say by sales return, we are mean to say that some amount has been credited, that is cash has been credited. Okay, so basically by preparing this account, I mean to say that on the left side our debit account is placed and on the right side our credit account is placed. These are the two terms without which the format of any account is incomplete. So you should be very careful while preparing account that you have placed debit and credit on the right side. Okay, now coming towards our last term of the basic term, that is sixth term, known as proprietor. Who is known as proprietor? We call proprietor as owner as well. Who is the owner now? The one who invests the amount in the business and also bear profits as well as losses in the business. Say, if you are investing some amount in a business or somewhere, it's obvious that the profit you will earn on the investment is your, but in case there are any losses, then you also have to bear such losses on that investment. And if you are investing that amount and bearing the profit as well as loss, you will call owner or the proprietor of that business. With these 6 points, our basic terms of this of our accounting terms are finished. Now we'll learn further transactions, further terms in our next slide. Okay.